Yo, brawlers, this is your man, Glass Chin, and you're watching Glass Chin's Boxing. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Yo, brawlers, so I stated in my Dillian White versus Jermaine Franklin video yesterday that Sporting Icons had leaked that Anthony Joshua was in talks to fight Gerald Washington next. Well, Eddie Hearn has said today that Joshua's next fight is going to be in probably January, maybe February, but it's now likely to be a rematch with Dillian White. How is Dillian White going to be ready for January when he's fighting Jermaine Franklin on the 26th of November, giving him just an 8-week window in between the fights? Obviously, that's not going to happen unless Hearn really does see Franklin just as a complete knockover job. January, that's just too soon. February is more realistic, giving White a couple of weeks rest and a full 8 to 10 week camp. Just seems unlikely that Hearn will make that fight without Joshua having a tune-up first. Hearn did say that Otto Wallin was still an option for Joshua, but still no mention of Chris Arreola or Washington, who have both claimed that they have been contacted about the fight by Matchroom. Hearn denied that there had been talks with Arreola a few weeks ago, and to my knowledge, no one has questioned him about Washington yet. But Arreola did confirm after the Wilder fight that Matchroom had reached out to him. Apparently, Malik Scott, who is Washington's trainer, leaked this news. Apparently, Scott and Washington have both been in the same gym that Dillian White is now training in and working with his new trainer, Buddy McGirt. Scott has said that Matchroom have contacted him about the fight with Washington. I would take what Scott is saying with a pinch of salt, but who knows, maybe it's true, maybe it's not, but personally I'm just not buying into it. Yeah, I was surprised by how many people on Sporting Icons channel was giving Joshua a free pass for this potential fight with Washington and jumping to Joshua's defence. To me, this is a pointless trash fight. I'm all for Joshua having a softer touch. I'm somewhat giving Fury, Wilder and White a break for their easier options that they have taken recently. Then maybe I should have, taking fights with Chisora, Hellenius and Franklin. A lot of people was using Wilder fighting Hellenius as a reason to why Washington is okay for Joshua, seeing as Washington beat Hellenius back in the summer of 2019. There are a couple of reasons why I give Wilder a pass and I don't give one to Joshua. Hellenius was world ranked 5th with the WBC. It was ordered as a first eliminator, with the winner to fight the winner of Ruiz and Ortiz in a final eliminator next year. It's a means to an end to Wilder, although a little bit dodgy that it was all PBC fighters involved, but it gets Wilder right back into the title mix. Also, Hellenius knocked out and beat Adam Kownacki twice, who beat Washington, Charles Martin and Chris Arreola all back to back. Hellenius was 6-1 in his last 7 fights, and as I said, he was world ranked. Washington has lost 5 of his last 7 fights, all 5 of them by knockout. He hasn't won a fight in over 3.5 years since his win over Hellenius. Hellenius was on the up while Washington is now completely out of the world title picture. He's nowhere near the top 15 rankings. What does Joshua get out of this fight? Even if Wilder didn't get a workout against Hellenius or a chance to show what he's been working on in the gym, he got a final eliminator out of it. Don't get me wrong, Wilder was out of the ring for a year after the loss to Fury. He needs to get some rounds in the bank. Hellenius turned out to be terrible prep for Ruiz Jr. But with Wilder, you never know when that knockout is coming. Hearn stated, "Don't be surprised if Hellenius beats Wilder before the fight, due to his lack of technical ability." Lots of people actually gave Hellenius a chance to take Wilder deep, and many see him as a live opponent. Obviously, in reality, it turned out to be a complete knockover job, but that wasn't the general feeling before the fight. Joshua gets nothing out of fighting Washington. It doesn't position him up the rankings for any eliminators. Unless he completely carries Washington, I don't think he will get any kind of workout in this fight. I'd expect it to be like the Charles Martin or Eric Molina fights, where he'll just blow him out in a couple of rounds. It's no secret that Joshua stepped up to world level quick and has been learning on the job. He came to boxing late, and within 4 years he was Olympic gold champion, and turning pro after 3 years he was fighting for world titles. He didn't get all them years of amateur experience fighting all them different types of styles. He only had 15 pro bouts before challenging for a world title, and the spotlight was on him from the beginning. Other than the Dillian White fight for the British title, he didn't really have many troubles. White troubled him a little bit, but it was pretty much one-way traffic all the way up to the Klitschko fight. It's good for him to take a step down from the elite, but how big a step backwards should he take? He may have lost his last 2 fights to Usyk, but they were on points to possibly the best heavyweight in the world, possibly the pound-for-pound number one. The Joshua that turned up for the rematch was so much better than the Joshua that turned up for the first fight, who pretty much handed his titles to Usyk. There was lots of positives to take from that performance. It was really only his engine that lost him the fight in the championship rounds. He was ahead on the scorecards going into the 10th and arguably had his best round in the 9th round where he hurt Usyk, but unfortunately punched himself out.
Why not build on that performance? If Joshua is out until February, that's 6 months out of the ring again. He's only had 5 fights in 4 years, and of course he's going to come into these fights ring rusty. What will he achieve by blowing Washington out in a couple of rounds? What is the point in that? At least Chris Arreola, for me, is a much better fight. It's a better stay busy fight. Yeah, Joshua will be favourite to win that one and should win it by stoppage. But Arreola will bring pressure and he will go out on his shield. He will give Joshua a lot to think about. He's the perfect warm-up fight for White next year. I mean, I like Otto Wallin, and that is a fight that I would like to see. But what is the point of him fighting a southpaw next if White and Fury are the fights that Joshua wants in the near future? If he fights a southpaw, surely an in-house fight with Zhang Zhili would be the smarter business option to take. That's a fight just outside of the top 10, but it gets Joshua that workout. I don't know, brawlers, maybe I'm giving Joshua too hard a time. I just think at least Franklin and Hellenius were world ranked, and Wilder and White, unlike Joshua, were both on the back of knockout losses, quite bad knockout losses. Joshua was physically and mentally drained after the Usyk fight, but he didn't get beat up bad in that fight. If he has a quick turnaround after Washington fights again in maybe April or May, then maybe I'll give him a pass too. I don't know, brawlers, I'm just not too excited about this one, and hopefully it's just fake news and Malik Scott hasn't been in contact with Matchroom and the fight's not happening. Hopefully we get news next week that Joshua will be fighting Arreola or Wallin. Anyway, brawlers, what's your thoughts on this fight if it is true? Let me know in the comments section, and as always, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video.